Good morning. It's my pleasure to be here today with all of you, and especially my colleague and friend, Minister Derek Johnson, Municipal Relations Minister, from what I consider the most spectacular historic building in all of the province of Manitoba, our Manitoba Legislature. And there are nearly 1,000 officially recognized historical sites throughout our beautiful province that serve as reminders of our province's past and the people that came before us. We live, work, and play in around these wonderful buildings each and every day, and our government is committed to preserving and enhancing these places so that future generations can learn about our province's rich and diverse history. Budget 2021 is about protecting Manitobans during COVID-19 and advancing Manitoba and the economy past COVID-19. And as part of Budget 2021, our government is very proud to invest $25 million for the creation of the Bay Building Fund to support projects that will restore, preserve, or maintain the heritage elements of the historic Hudson's Bay Company building. The first store was built in 1882 and was located at the corner of Main Street and York Avenue, and it was vacated when the new building was completed. Originally constructed in 1926, it was built in subdued neoclassical or classical revival style, which became the Hudson's Bay Company's corporate style for buildings thereafter. The building has seen many changes over the last century and was granted heritage status by the City of Winnipeg in 2019. It assumes a massive building footprint covering more than 500,000 square feet and taking up nearly an entire city block. The Bay serves as a landmark along the route leading from Portage Avenue to the Legislative Building and is adjacent to other important landmarks of heritage value like the Winnipeg Art Gallery, the Provincial Archive Building, the Vaughan Street Jail, and of course, our beautiful Legislative Building. All this to say, Manitobans have many memories attached to the Bay Building. It was more than just a retail location. It's part of our province's heritage and the social fabric of our downtown Winnipeg. And I know that we all have fond memories of our shopping visits to the Bay. I vividly recall the opportunity to visit the Bay and have lunch with my girlfriends at the Paddle Wheel Restaurant. That is something I'll never forget. We always wanted to have that seat right by the Paddle Wheel. So our government is pleased to make this very significant $25 million investment, and we look forward to the inspiration of private enterprise and other levels of government to unlock the potential that awaits for the redevelopment of this landmark building and vibrant neighborhood. The $25 million fund is being held in trust by the Winnipeg Foundation, and eligible projects can be completed over a 10-year period. And those projects could include conservation efforts to restore identified heritage elements of the building, such as the building facade and the interior curved elevator bank. Capital repairs, such as structural repair and building stabilization, or the creation and installation of exhibits in the very, very large display windows on the main floor or another location within the building depicting the history of the Hudson's Bay building. If the entire $25 million is not utilized by 2031, any remaining amount will be transferred to the province's Heritage Resources Endowment Fund to support other provincial and municipal heritage sites. Our government recognizes the importance of preserving our past and investing in our future. And we believe this significant contribution will help support the continued growth of the City of Winnipeg. And now I'd like to turn it over to my colleague, Minister Johnson.
Good morning. As mentioned, I'm Derek Johnson, Minister of Municipal Relations, and thank everybody for joining us here today. As Minister Cox stated, the province's 2021 budget is about protecting and advancing Manitoba's services and economy past COVID-19. Much of our economic growth lives in our cities and our communities. A healthy and vibrant downtown is crucial for economic growth in the City of Winnipeg and building a more prosperous Manitoba. A push to revitalize downtown has transpired over the last few years, including the new Inuit Arts Centre True North Square, and Memorial Park. The redevelopment of the Bay Building would be a great addition to the continued vitality of downtown Winnipeg. With $25 million investment into the Bay Building, our government is committing nearly $300 million to the City of Winnipeg for infrastructure and service agreements. This support is one of the most generous municipal funding programs in the country. In Budget 2021, our government is also committed to phasing out education property tax, starting with a 10% reduction for commercial properties in 2021. Businesses will benefit from these reductions to help build towards growing Winnipeg and all communities in our province, while also creating jobs for Manitobans. Our government recognizes the importance of municipalities in advancing Manitoba. We are happy to announce this substantial investment to the Bay Building Fund and will continue to support the diverse needs of our communities across the province. Thank you, and back to Minister Cox.
Thank you so much. And today's announcement really reaffirms our government's commitment to support the conservation and long-term sustainability of Manitoba's heritage resources so that Manitobans and visitors can come to our beautiful province and enjoy these sites for years to come. Over the past few years, our government has established a $15 million endowment that triples the amount of funding available to support heritage buildings through the Manitoba Heritage Resources Conservation Grant, and $2 million to establish the Military Memorial Conservation Grant, both of which will remain in perpetuity. As well, our government has committed $150 million to repair and revitalize the Manitoba Legislative Building and ensure that it remains accessible for future generations. We are proud to protect our past and invest in the future to build a healthier, stronger, more prosperous Manitoba for all. And now I'm going to open it up to questions. Thank you.
Thank you, ministers. A reminder to reporters on the line, you will have one question, one follow-up. We'll start with the Winnipeg Free Press and Martin.
Thanks. Congratulations on having the foresight to make this money available. Can I ask both of you, are there actual redevelopment concepts or schemes or projects that the government is in discussion with other parties? The funding sounds like it's conserving the heritage status, but in fact, future use, that is there redevelopment in play?
Well, thank you, and that's an excellent question. At this point in time, the owner of the building is the Hudson's Bay Company, and we encourage them to invite either the private sector or other levels of government to invest in this project. And have had no discussions with any possible proponents of what type of projects they plan to host in this building. There are some concerns with regard to what has to be preserved, and like the four limestone facades, the walls, they have to be preserved. The entrances, the five entrances in the building have to be preserved. The rounded corners at the top of the building, we don't have any influence on what type of project the Bay Building might have potentially in the future.
You said that the funding needs to be deployed by 2031. Should we take it to mean that that you're sort of contemplating that the building will could potentially sit empty for another 10 years?
Well, we certainly hope not, and that's the reason for this investment. We really want to trigger some interest in revitalizing this beautiful, iconic building as it sits right on the corner of Memorial Boulevard and Portage Avenue. It's been there nearly 100 years. 1926 will be its 100-year anniversary, and we do want to encourage growth and revitalization in this area of the City of Winnipeg.
Thank you, Martin. Now, from CGOB, we go to Will.
Good morning, ministers. So there are some people who might say heritage designations stifle innovation and maybe push away potential investors because of those costs that are associated with the upkeep. What would be your response to that position?
Well, that's exactly why we're investing this money right now, because we know that, it may be more expensive to restore an aging building, but we want to ensure that those individuals who step up to restore this building have the funds in place, and they know that those funds will be there, up until 2031. It may take a little bit of time to develop a plan, but by investing this money, we're also encouraging other levels of government and private sector to also make investments.
Okay, thanks. And I don't want to get too far ahead of where we are right now, but if that building were to sit empty for another 5 or 10 years, is the government prepared to make other moves potentially, maybe buy the building?
No. Under the agreement, our government, provincial government, is not able to take ownership of that building. This is really to encourage development, to revitalize, this very beautiful, iconic building, and also the city of Winnipeg.
Thank you. Thank you. Moving now to the Winnipeg Sun and Josh.
Good morning, ministers. Quick question. How did you guys arrive at $25 million for this fund? Was that something that was indicated to you by Hudson Bay Company, or is that just how did you guys get to $25 million for this?
Well, this is really, a substantial amount of money. It's a considerable investment, and we know that by investing $25 million, we hope that others will step up with other significant, investments, perhaps the other levels of government, the federal government, because it really is an important project. And, 100 years from now, people are going to be looking back at what's happening right now with COVID. We want to ensure that this building remains available for future generations, because it really is too important. It's an iconic building.
Okay, and when we look at the funding parameters for projects, it does have to have anything that the provincial money is going into? Does it have to have tie-in from other organizations or other levels of government, or can it just be something fully funded from the provincial government? And who's deciding what projects get done or not? Is it just going to be the Winnipeg Foundation?
Well, this is, $25 million from our province. And again, it's to encourage other levels of government and the private sector to step up. We will not have any influence on what type of projects locate inside that building. But there are conditions that are placed with regard to, what has to remain, what is considered heritage. We look forward to hearing from individuals on, it's the Hudson's Bay Company is still the owner of the building. And so I know that they, have the opportunity to look at those projects and, ensure that those very important heritage aspects of the building remain intact.
And now we go to CBC, Ian.
Good morning, ministers. As you've expressed earlier, Minister Cox, I mean, you're not focused on private players at this point in time, but why not devote some of this money towards private players that could either buy the building or become tenants in it? Because I think we all want to see, someone get into this building again.
Yeah, and absolutely. I mean, this is not, saying that private sector can't get involved. We're encouraging, with this $25 million investment, other levels of government, the private sector, to get involved in the restoration of this beautiful building. There's many opportunities, and we feel that by committing $25 million, it's a significant amount. It really provides for opportunity and revitalization of this building, and as well, this very important part of our city of Winnipeg.
Why not devote money, though, to help private players?
Could you repeat your question?
Yes. Oh, sorry. I know you're encouraging, but why not devote money towards private players?
Well, I mean, this money will be available to private players. The Bay may, decide to relinquish, the ownership of this building, and in fact, it may be, the private sector step in to redevelop and restore this building. And I'm sure that I look forward to really lots of exciting opportunities and to hearing the different projects that they may have in mind to host within this building.
Okay, that's through the list of reporters on the call, but we do have a few minutes. Let's spend a few minutes at the wide open questions. Are there any other questions from any other media? Again, please identify yourself and pose your questions now.
Thanks. If I could, it's Martin Cash at the Free Press. Mr. Cox, you said in your remarks in one of the questions that the province would not be in a position or would not be prepared to acquire the building. Could you just elaborate on that? Why not?
Well, it's one of the conditions that's within the agreement. And, we've invested $25 million, and we know that we have individuals out there, whether it's private sector, who have great ideas and suggestions to redevelop this beautiful, iconic building. So that's within the agreement, and we feel that giving the private sector or the Hudson Bay Company the opportunity to move forward with new projects is the most beneficial way to see this project or to see this area of the city revitalized.
Thanks.
Any other questions?
I have Martin Cash of the Free Press with another.
Go ahead, Martin. Your line is breaking up, though.
Thanks. The Winnipeg Foundation is administering the fund, and I believe, Mr. Cox, you did say that the Bay would have some say as to the project that will be approved. Maybe could you elaborate on that just a bit more as well?
Well, the Bay will have the opportunity to, if they choose to, have another a private sector be involved in the project. That's really up to them, or if in fact they want to retain the building. But really, I mean, we as the government of Manitoba are not putting any limitations on who can own the building or on the projects. As long as they adhere to all of the historic conditions that are currently on the Bay building, we look forward to seeing that building revitalized and moving and, into a thriving building where we can see a growth in the city of Winnipeg.
Will there be a cap on each project, maximum amount per project?
Well, we've said very clearly that we've put $25 million, into this fund right now. We've seen that in the past, previous governments have made commitments, and, then they can change their mind quite often before elections. There's commitments that are made. We've invested $25 million with the Winnipeg Foundation, as certainty and to provide them, with that money so that money is can never be, we can never say, in fact, we've changed our mind or we don't have the funds available. That money is there with certainty, for those organizations that are interested in constructing or restoring that beautiful building.
And on that note, we need to wrap things up. So thank you, ministers. Thank you, media. This concludes our morning press conference.